Hi students, welcome back. So in the previous video I explained about what exactly the embedded system was. The embedded system is a combination of hardware and software, and it is designed to perform a particular task that has to be completed in a given time. That you call it as embedded system. So the different examples for embedded systems are mobile phones, robots, refrigerators, microwave, washing machine, televisions, all comes under the examples, different examples of embedded system. So let me explain the building blocks of embedded system. So what components you require to build embedded system? Building blocks of, let me write ES, embedded system. So if you want to construct any embedded system, what are the building, what are the main components that you require? The first thing is, you need input. For whatever the component you have taken, you need to give the input, and the final is you'll get the output. So if you take the washing machine, you're putting the clothes on that, and it is going to perform operation, and it is going to wash your clothes and give the drained clothes. Okay, so that is the output. So in between that, you need some controller to perform the operation. Controller. So for input, controller and output, you are giving the input, some time you are giving, so in that particular time it has to be completed. The controller is doing the operation and it output is giving. So this is everything is a performing single task only. It is depends upon particular task, it is performing a single task. So if want to do all these things, you need some power supply. Power supply you needed. Okay, input is there, output is there, controller is there, power supply is there. Still, what you require? Frequency generator, means a crystal oscillator you required, because the time has to be, whatever the work it is doing, that has to be completed in that particular time. For that, you need frequency generator. So, for that, we will use the crystal oscillator. Okay, so the controller, again the power supply, and finally you will get the output. So what are the inputs that you will take? Let's take the different, what are the different inputs that are the main building blocks of embedded systems, or the input, output. You just think generally. So whatever the equipment you are taking, whatever the device you are taking, just take the device and think, what are the inputs for that and what are the outputs for that, and whether we are giving the power supply or not, and what work it is going, what type of controllers we are using on that system, and is the frequency generator is present or not. So that you have to be think. So let's see what are the different inputs. The different inputs for the embedded system is sensors, buttons. You can use the buttons as an input, or you can use the touch panels also. So like in mobile phones, you will use the touch panels, or you can use a Bluetooth as an input, Bluetooth, and IR, infrared rays. Like for TV remotes, you will use the IR, infrared rays. So these are all the different inputs that are connect to the controller. So power supply, you know, and the output is, the output may be present on in the form of LEDs, LCDs, or even Bluetooth. Output may be appeared, means whenever you are connected to a device, Bluetooth input and output can be played in the Bluetooth output device also, and IR. And now let's see the controllers. What are the different controllers that we can use in the embedded system? ROM, read-only memory, RAM, arithmetic logic unit, and the control unit. So these are all comes under the controller. So ROM is a only the code should be present permanently stored in the ROM. We all know that ROM is a read-only memory. Only the permanent data will be stored. So that's why we call it as a code memory. A code memory will be present on the controller, and the RAM is a runtime data memory. So after whenever the system is working, so whatever the data that it needs, that variables will be stored in the RAM. So that's why we call it as a runtime data memory. And we all know that ALU is arithmetic logic unit performing all the calculations, and the control unit is going to control all the operations. And here we use a frequency generator, we use a crystal oscillator. The crystal oscillator, which is used for time, it is setting the time for a particular task. So these are the building blocks of embedded system. So you need power supply, input, output, controller, and frequency generator. That's it. Thank you.